Before I give my sermon tonight, first I want to sincerely thank you for turning up in really unexpected numbers today. And it's just nice to see the ground at St. Anne's full of people that have come together today as an act of faith to ceremonially bring a close to the year of mercy. So thank you very much, Nakvalevu, Korapa, Sheshe, and what else? Faxia. Last week I was in Vatukuda to open a church and also do confirmation, then came through Kumbulau to give the Ratu Emery school a generator for their school, and then spent the night in Solevu. While I was in Nambawalu, I saw a truck, 4x4 truck, and at the back of the truck, it has these words at the back of the truck, Year of Mercy. I don't know whether that's only in Bua, but definitely for the people in Bua, the truck would be giving a big message around the whole of Lambasa, wherever it went to, about the Year of Mercy. So we should really thank the owner of that truck. One of Pope Francis's words to one of his public addresses was, "The doors of God's mercy does not close. The doors of God's mercy does not close." So today, while we ceremonially close the year of mercy, but in fact we are really leaving that door open in our hearts and in our churches, that God's mercy will not only be closed, but be more openly opened and shared and proclaimed to the world. So today, while we bring a close to this year of mercy, I'd like to remind us just a few key themes that the Pope talks about in his letter, Misericordia Vultus. So he says that this year will be a time to gaze more attentively on the mercy of God and become a more effective sign of God's mercy. Nembangondo nangona menda wana nova matua wawasuma na nona loloma kawai na klu. Merao talanga ni wangitikenda menda ndau loloma menda ndau wikawaitaki. And that is one of the key themes of the Pope, that we spend time to contemplate, to meditate on the mercy of God. Why? And he makes 4 points that I'd like to remind us again. Number one is that mercy is God's fundamental attribute. That means mercy is one of the key nature of God. That is what God is. God is mercy. And that is the way that God reveals himself or God comes to meet us. Na na kawai ndona tikimbimbi se avutu se ndurvesi na nona mbul na klo ngona na 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 kanda kla wana klo se ni wale wale varita ki kenda bi varita koi bi kenda na klo na nona kawai te kenda. Second point is that Jesus reveals the Father's mercy to the world and us. And through Jesus, mercy has become living and visible. So for us, Jesus is important to our faith, you know. We have other devotions to Mary, devotions to saints, but our key way of coming to know God is through Jesus, and Jesus reveals to us the mercy of God by the way he lived, what he preached, the people that he stood for and spoke for, and eventually that he will die for. And so Jesus reveals to us, so we should hold Jesus, our devotion to Jesus and his word, very close to our heart. This should be the center of our life. We Christians should be known by the way we live, and that is how we follow the life, the teachings of Jesus. The third point that Pope Francis says that in the whole of the Bible, mercy is a key word that indicates God's action towards us. So God first revealed himself because he was concerned, he was moved with pity with the people of Israel, how they were oppressed and persecuted and suffered under Pharaoh and the Egyptians. And so he says to Moses, I have seen the affliction of my people who are in Egypt, and I have heard their cry because of their taskmasters. And I know their sufferings, and I have come down to deliver them out of the hand of Egypt. So the first time that God reveals him is because of his mercy. And this is the way God reveals himself. He reveals himself as a God of mercy. The final point that I'd like to make that is important for us to remember today as we open and reopen the door of mercy, and that is about the church. The Pope says, mercy is the very foundation of the church's life. All of her pastoral activity should be caught up in the tenderness and she makes present to believers. Nothing in her preaching and in her witness can be lacking in mercy. The church's very credibility is seen in how she shows mercy and compassion. So those words speak for itself. I'll just say a few words in Fijian. Na kawai, tu na tu tambe ndua na yabu day inonda mbula vaya kelsia. Si ngo na watu etarke na kelsia. Kakenda na vaya dora na nonda taka taka vaya kelsia. Anga me vata kile kile taka. Na nona kawai na nona klu. Nonda wulotu. Na nonda vare taka na nonda taka taka vaya postolo. Anga me kena uta chuko na nonda kaweta kira na wira erangandra wana vivuke. Etuko na tuitambu na nandina niya kele siya siya na merau ni rambo tikenda na ve mata tamata talia so ningondo na ekele sinda ekele siya ndina na rau na non rambo ta me na non rareza na ninda vareta kandona mbula ya kawai Donambula, Ndaulolama. So those are, just to remind us, that as we close the door of mercy today, the Pope, through this year of mercy, really wants to heighten, wants to intensify, wants to fill us with the Spirit of God, and that is the Spirit of mercy. And so as we, so it's really, the whole year of mercy is to fill us with that Spirit, the Spirit of God, and that is the Spirit of mercy. And so early this year, the Council of Priests planned out some activities that could be held out in parishes and schools. And we only planned one diocesan activity, and that is in conjunction with the Divine Mercy, which was held on the second Sunday of Easter. Our education week adopted the Pope's theme, Merciful Like the Father. And then we designated three shrines throughout the diocese, the Holy Family Shrine, the shrine at Ashram, and the shrine at Nazareth Prayer Center. I want to take this time to sincerely thank you all, the parish priests, catechists, sisters, brothers, and teachers for contributing to the year of mercy. Thank you very much. Furthermore, there were events this year that called for mercy, or the practice of mercy. In particular, the cyclone Winston, which we all know the destruction that it brought to our country, called for great witness in mercy. The Archdiocese of Suva this year did her best to respond in a more organized way, or in the words of Pope Benedict, to organize our love. So we carried out some assessments. With the help of Caritas, we were able to help some people with shelters. We responded to those people who were traumatized by the cyclone. And this has also taught us, and especially me, how to organize the works of mercy and the works of love in the future. In the first week of December, we will hold our clergy convocation, and one of the key themes of that convocation is to structure our disaster management and to help our parishes and our villages to be prepared for the disaster instead of reacting after a disaster happens. We will be putting out some containers in the near future, and then coming week, so that we can prepare and fill up containers so that we can immediately respond in works of mercy to those who might suffer in the future cyclone that come. So today, while we close the year of mercy, does not mean closing the door of God's mercy. In fact, this whole year and the years to come and our whole life should be filled with works of mercy, corporal works of mercy, and also spiritual works of mercy. As I said, the year of mercy, like the previous years, year for the family and other years that the popes have dedicated, are all meant to heighten our awareness of God and His love. And this year, it's about the mercy of God. And so as we close this door, we pray that as church, as individuals, we will continue to experience God's mercy, receive His mercy, and to share that mercy with the whole of society. Today's reading also helps us in this reflection. They are what we call apocalyptic kind of writing. They speak about the end of time, in the book of Malachi. And Malachi says, "Lo, the day is coming, blazing like an oven, when all the proud and all evildoers will stumble. And the day is coming, that day that is coming will set them on fire, leaving them neither root nor branch." The Gospel of St. Luke also speaks about disasters, insurrections, wars. But he encourages that we should not be terrified, because these things will happen first. Nations will rise against nation, kingdom against kingdom. There will be powerful earthquakes and famines and plagues, and awesome sights, mighty signs that will come down from the sky. These apocalyptic writings are meant to also heighten our preparedness for the coming of the kingdom of God. The apocalyptic writers remind us that there is an end to time. But it's not an empty end. It's a time for the coming of kingdom, the coming of God's mercy, the coming of God's justice. The apocalyptic writings tell us what is to come at the end of the time, and also calls us to prepare for that, to prepare for God's mercy, to prepare for God's justice, by the way we live today, and that is through our works of mercy and works of justice. And it tells us that through this, we prepare for that time, the God's time and God's rule. And so the readings today also remind us that end is not an end, but it's a new beginning of God's rule. And so as we approach the end of the liturgical year, as we think about the end of times, let us not be disheartened. Let us not be fearful. But being faithful to the works of mercy and the works of God's kingdom, we will be good disciples and we will prepare for the second coming of God and help God's kingdom come. And so as we continue then on our liturgy today, let us join all the cathedrals in the world. Remember, we are not only one doing this. The whole world today gathers to give thanks and praise to God for all the graces we have received from the year of mercy and also the graces that we will receive and work for in the years to come. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.